There's always so many exciting things being announced at San Diego Comic-Con.
The World According to Jon.
Hello and welcome to The World According to Jon. My name is, as you know, Jonathan Paula, returning from a three-week vacation. Sorry for the absence and apologies for the suntan. Let's get down to business. This week in San Diego, the, let's say, 44th annual San Diego Comic-Con is going on. 130,000 people are in attendance, and they're soaking in all of the great comic book, movie, television, and pop culture news. And a convention I definitely wish I could be attending, but sadly I don't have the money or the time to go down there this week. But I have been following closely with all the news coming out of that convention, and I wanted to share some of the bigger moments that caught my attention earlier this weekend. First things first, 2 days ago, Zack Snyder, the director of the upcoming Batman vs. Superman film, tweeted out this picture of Batfleck, Ben Affleck as the new Batman. He has the scowl, he has the chin, the stubby little bat ears. It's a cool image, and just one more little breadcrumb that he's been teasing us with until the movie comes out. I can't believe it's this far off, May 6, 2016. We also, earlier today, got a full image of Gal Gadot, or is it Gal Gadot, as Wonder Woman, looking sexy, gritty, dark, fine-looking legs on that woman, and it looks like some practical armor, like she's gonna move around and really kill some guys, and maybe she gets in between Supes and Batman. I can only wait and see. So some cool Batman vs. Superman news and some new images to tide us over, because again, the movie is still 2 years out there. And speaking of comic book films, we also have a new teaser image for Age of Ultron, the Avengers sequel. Lots of stuff going on in this image. You can blow it up, save it as a desktop background. I'll leave a link in the description below. But you have Iron Man, you have Hulk, you have Jeremy Renner in there, and they're fighting a bunch of robot bad guys. I have no idea what any of this means. I don't read the comic books. I love the films, don't get me wrong. But so far, this is like, okay, great, more of the same. That's all I need to know. You have my money already. I am excited for Avengers 2. That comes out May of 2015. Also, there was a panel earlier in the week for 24 Live Another Day. But sadly, the panel did not give us any new news regarding a sequel follow-up, another event series, another season of the show. For fans like me of 24, you might have been disappointed with the Live Another Day finale, which seemed to end on a sort of cliffhanger. It works as a great season finale, but not as a great series finale. And if that's the last we ever see of Jack Bauer, I will be honestly a bit disappointed. And I was hoping that this SDCC panel would kind of say, oh, you know what? That did really well. We are going to come back with a season 10. No news yet. I'm keeping my ears peeled because it's one of my all-time favorite shows. But for now, you can probably just check out Kiefer's Q&A at the convention. But the biggest news of the weekend, at least for me, was the announcement that Sam Raimi will be directing a Last of Us feature film adaptation. Oh my god, brain explosion! The Last of Us is one of my all-time favorite video games, having only played it just last summer. I did a full Let's Play here on Jon's World and a review of it, and you know already I adore this game. The story is fantastic, and I said many times in my Let's Play that, by all accounts, this game rivals most traditional cinema in the story department, especially since it's a 15-16 hour campaign where you can really expand on the characters and get underneath their skin. I would love to see what they can do in a 2 hour feature film. We also have Massey Williams from Game of Thrones, who is possibly going to be tapped to play Ellie in the film. And as for the Joel character, I would love to see Dylan McDermott because he looks so damn similar. Hugh Jackman's name has been floating around, as well as Josh Brolin. All excellent choices. I don't really care who you get to play it. It'd be cool if you could get Troy Baker, but he sounds obviously exactly like Joel, but doesn't quite look the part, and he's a bit too young to play the 54-year-old in the movie. Really excited for the Last of Us film. No idea when that will come out or who's going to be in it. We only have a couple glimpses and rumors so far, but I'm intrigued as to how and where Bruce Campbell will pop up in a cameo role, Raimi's longtime collaborator. Maybe he'll show up as a clicker in the final act. And finally, in related but non-Comic-Con news, earlier this week, director J.J. Abrams from the set of Star Wars 7 released another promotional video for his charity Force for Change, where we got to see a full-scale, newly designed X-Wing replica standing right next to him. It looks fantastic, and it's yet another little glimpse of a film that is, and I'm not exaggerating here, probably the most anticipated I've ever been for any film ever. Star Wars 7. I'm totally excited for that film, and I'm guessing you are too. So some cool news from London, and plenty of news from Southern California. Let me know what your thoughts are on all the stuff I talked about in this video in the comments down below. But for now, that is The World According to Me. My name is Jonathan Paula. Thank you for watching and listening. I hope to see you right back here in the very near future.